The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada.
Dehi samsparja samsparsaja bhoga dukho jonaya eva te abhyanta bhanta Kaunteya Nateshu Ramate Buddha. Happiness, which is derived by touch senses, sansparsaja means happiness, so-called happiness derived by touch senses. Jehi sansparsaja bhoga, enjoyment. Dukha jonaya eva te. Lord Krishna says that is not real happiness. Any happiness derived out of touch sensation, that is not real happiness, rather that is the gate of various misery. The whole Vedic scripture describes that happiness derived of sense perception out of this body, that is not real happiness. If we have to enjoy real happiness, then we have to transcend this bodily pleasure. Happiness is there because I am spirit soul. Actually, I am full of pleasure, but because my sense of happiness is being manifested through this matter, therefore we are being frustrated in deriving real pleasure. So those who are in the advanced in the spiritual life, they are called yogis. Yogina, ramante yogina anante. Those who are spiritual, they also enjoy, but they enjoy in real happiness which has no end. Any happiness which is ended at a certain point, that is not happiness. That is rather source of distress. Abhyantamanta Kaunteya Nateshu Ramate Buddha. Buddha means who is learned. A learned person does not enjoy such flickering or transient happiness which is derived by sense touching. Sanak saknoti haiva jasurum prak sarira vimapsana kāma-krodha bhavam-vegam sa jitta sa suti nara. Saknoti means one who is able to tolerate. Ihaiva means in this body. Sorum means to tolerate. Prak means before. Sarira vimakshana, before leaving this body, if one practices that, what is that practice? Krama, kama, krodha, bhavam, vegam. Vegam means urge. Just like sex urge. Everyone has got sex urge. Or so many things, you have got some urge. Now, that Krishna advises that before quitting this body. The example is that suppose a man is diseased, is suffering from a type of disease, and doctor has asked him not to take solid food. Now, he is thinking that because he's practiced to take solid food, he is thinking, I must take solid food. I must take solid food. But if he can tolerate, no, doctor has advised not to take solid food. If he can tolerate, then he becomes very easily cured. Similarly, sense perception, sense pleasure is reserved for us in our spiritual life. That is actual sense pleasure. Yet, we are having sense pleasure artificially through this body. Before leaving this body, if we practice to stop sense pleasure as much as possible, there is training, of course. Without training, nothing can be done. So according to Vedic civilization, this training was given. The student life, complete abstinence from sex life. Then, vanaprastha life, complete abstinence. And sannyas life, complete abstinence. The whole training was to abstain, to cure. Because, the same example, in disease condition, we cannot enjoy the foodstuff which we take. When we are healthy, we can enjoy the taste of the food. So we have to cure. We have to cure. And how to cure? Now, to be situated in the transcendental position of Krishna consciousness. That is the cure. The Krishna advises here, anyone who is able to tolerate the urge of sense pleasure, so long this body is there, there will be urges for sense pleasure. But we have to mold our life in such a way that we should be able to tolerate. That will give us our advancement in spiritual life. And when we are situated in spiritual life, that enjoyment is unending, unlimited. There is no end. Exactly a similar passage is there in Srimad Bhagavatam. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, the Rishabdev is advising his son that Nayam Deha Deho Bhajan Nilope Kastan Kaman Arhati Birbhujamidi. Tapo Vidyam Putraka Jena Satya Suddhet Jasmat Dhamma Sukham Ananta. It is very nice. But he says, my dear boy, this human form of life, now I am a Deha means this body. Now I am a Deha, Deho Bhajang Niloke. Everyone has got body. The cats, dogs, hogs, and birds, bees, man, human beings, demigod, everyone has got this body, material body. But he is especially advising Nri Deha. Nri means human form of life. He says that this human form of life is not meant for working hard for sense pleasure just like the hogs and dogs. He is advised. Then what it is meant for? He says, tapah dibbam. One should undergo penance for transcendental realities. And what will be the result of such penance? He says that jato suddheta satya, your existence will be purified. And when your existence is purified, then you will enjoy brahma sukham, the unlimited spiritual happiness. You are hankering after happiness. Happiness is your prerogative. You must have. That is your life. You cannot stop happiness. But happiness in the disease condition is not happiness. That we must understand. So we have to cure this disease condition and then enjoy happiness, then enjoy pleasure that will be unlimited. There will be no end. And in the disease condition, suppose whatever pleasure you take, it is for a few seconds, or a few minutes, or a few hours, a few days, it will end. But real happiness, what is real happiness, that is unending. Brahma sukham anantam. Anantam means unending. So we are meant for unending happiness. The Krishna advises here, the saknoti haiva ja surum prak sarira vimakshana, before quitting this material body, if one practices to tolerate the so-called adjas of sense pleasure, then he becomes very happy at the long run. He recommends it. And that is the real purpose of human form of life, that we should not derive, we should not try to derive that false happiness in this diseased condition of material life. This is temporary, that is not happiness, we should understand, and out of ignorance we are engaged to derive such kind of happiness, but that is not happiness. Real happiness is in spiritual life. We have to attain the spiritual life, and just a man tolerates so many things for being cured. Similarly, we have to practice tolerance. Then there will be urges, certainly, because we have practiced to this sense urges for so many births in the so many evolutionary process. Now, in this human form of life, we have to consider that I am not this body, I am spirit soul. So I have to search out the happiness of the spirit soul, and for that I have to train myself under superior guidance, as Arjuna has put himself under the guidance of Krishna.
Jivanta sukhantara rama tatha antar jyoti revaja sajogi brahma nirvanam brahma bhuta adhigacchati.
One who is aspiring after that transcendental happiness, which is called Brahma-sukha. One who is jo-anta-sukha, that Brahma-sukha is within, that Brahma-sukha is not without. Jo-anta-sukha antar-arama, and is happy and pacified by enjoying within, antar-sukha antar-arama, tatha antar-jyoti-revaja, and who is trying to find out the Brahma Jyoti, the fulgence of Brahma within, sa yogi Brahma Nirvana, that yogi is already situated in Brahma. Nirvana means ending all this material contamination. Brahma Bhuta Vigacchati, and he becomes a realized soul of the Brahma content.
Lavante Brahma Nirvana Rishaya Kina Kalmasa Chinna Daidha Jatatmana Sarva Bhuta Hite Rakaha.
Now Krishna says that Kina Kalmasa, one who is able to reduce the reaction of our sinful life. We must know it, that this material existence, either in any form, they are all reactions of our sinful life. That we must know. So, in any condition, it does not matter that a highly advanced person, educated, learned, rich, or beautiful, or anyone, that more or less, according to degree, they are all enjoying suffering the reaction of their past karma. And more or less, all the world, they are considered to be sinful. So, Kina Kalmasa means those who are trying to reduce the reaction of sinful activities, how? That by practicing that sense control. Sense control. The practice is that sense control. Just like a disease person. By controlling according to the prescription of the doctor, by controlling himself, he becomes reduced in the sufferings of the disease. The fever diminishes from 105 degrees to 102, then 100, then 99, then 98, he is cured. Similarly, we have to reduce the temperature. We haven't got to increase the temperature. We are just like increasing our temperature. We are thinking that by increasing the temperature, we shall be happy. We do not know that by increasing temperature, we shall never be happy. We have to decrease the temperature. Thank you very much.